Hello, my dear student. Hope you all are enjoying your studies and taking care of yourself. Now, today we are going to start another chapter, chapter 2 in economics. So, the title of the chapter is People as Resource. So, before going to start this chapter, we should know that India is a country which is diverse with a population, the second largest country in the world. And different type of population used to stay.
Population is an asset for the economy rather than liability.
First set of population, number one, is our infants. These infants are newborn babies. Those who used to depend upon adults. Okay, and second one are women. Those who are not employed, they are used to working at home, and these are housewives. And third type of population is of adults. We can say adults. And these adults are old people, both male and female. So this is one set of population, those who used to stay in a country. Another set of population is type of educated male and female. Another one, uneducated male or female, or girl or boy, we can say. Now, what happened? How we consider people as resource? When we analyze the complete system of population, then we categorize that which type of population will be considered as a resource. So, these infant, housewives and adult people, they used to depend upon those people who used to earn in their family, and they are productive for the nation. So, in this way we can say people, those who have good skill and ability to produce productivity or add national income, they are called as the people as resource. So under this category, educated people doesn't mean that they all are the resources for the nation or they are considered as resource. Because sometimes educated, they remain unemployed. So, those people who used to earn salary and release productive work for their firms or the industry or the working institutions, then they are only called as resource. Now, another way, educated people, those who are not earning, not employed, and they are remaining idle at home and they are not productive for the national income of the nation, then these kind of population is called as non-productive. Also, they are not the part of people as resource. So, after understanding the various categories of population of a country, let us make out the definition of people as resource. So, the working population of a nation existing their skill and ability. These two words are very important, skill and ability. Is called as people as resource. So finally we can say that people can become resource for a nation unless and until their ability and skill are not fruitful for the nation. It means if they started working with their skill and they have capability and they can produce any good productivity for the nation and can add the national income, then we can say that that set of population is a people as resource. Now further, this people as resource can be converted and framed into human capital. How this people as resource is being converted into human capital, let us see what are those important features through which we can convert people as resource into human capital. So for framing human capital, we need investment in their education. It means if we are providing and arranging good education facility to the complete or entire population, then we are making ready and preparing for the human resource. Now second process will be for framing human capital is investment in healthcare facilities. As it is well said, health is wealth. So if population is healthy and they are educated, definitely they are going to be the productive for the nation, for adding human capital. Now for this, government has launched several, we can say, scheme, and that we are going to study further. Next is investment in training. So these are the three inputs through which we can convert human resource or population as resource into human capital. So if investment is done in education, well education is given for the population, then further if we are taking care of their health and they are healthy after getting education, and after involving these two features, if we are giving them training for their particular skill, then we are preparing for the human capital. So these are the three steps through which we can prepare human capital. Hence, population is an asset for the economy of a country, not a liability. In this way, we understood how population is or can be converted into human capital. There are three methods of framing into human capital. Population as a resource we can convert into human capital. There are three ways. Number one, investment in education. And number two, we saw investment in their healthcare. And third one is training. Let us discuss the first aspect very briefly, investment in education. How investment in education can convert human resource as human capital. Means how human people as a resource can be converted into human capital. So this can be done by investing more and more into education. Let us see the example of China and Japan. Though these countries have highest population, but they are the most developed country in the world. How it is possible? How these countries are not poor in spite of being highest population? Why? Because these countries, they have taken care more and more in the investment of their education and healthcare. And they have given their population a wonderful skill-based training through which they can convert their human capital and benefit the nation and lead towards the growth. So this is how it is very important to do the investment towards the education. If we see the case of India, there are several programs and schemes which were being launched towards the promotion of education. Number one, we can say Sarva Siksha Abhiyan, SSA. Sarva Siksha Abhiyan is being launched, in which children are being motivated to get the education from the age of 6 to 14. Means they are compulsory to get the education till the age of 14. So in this way, we are promoting towards the education and we are investing money towards the education. After that, several girls' schools and other colleges and institutions are being opened so that girls can be also promoted towards the education and their skill can be also efficiently used for the growth of nation. Now again we can see towards the education, midday meal, wonderful scheme towards the poor community or the we can say poor people. Midday scheme in several government school, means almost in all government school, midday meal scheme is there so that attendance of the student can be maintained and they can be attracted more and more towards the school and education. So government has given a wonderful effort and shown wonderful effort towards the investment of education, and they are trying to make the population more and more educated and efficient so that further it can be converted into human capital for the growth of nation. It is very, very important to think about all these aspects. At human capital, we need to understand the second step, which is very important, that is investment towards the health facility. So investment towards the health facility means making the population healthy, and healthy population leads finally to the great progress and development of the nation. So this is how we can convert people as resource into human capital when we invest more and more towards the health facility, also by taking care of their health. So if we talk about government work towards or effort towards the public health facility, we have seen wonderful example. These days if we talk about, wonderful programs are being launched out of which people are getting benefit out of that. Ayushman Bharat, in which rural people, they are getting a lot of benefit from this program. And recently when country is facing the crisis from COVID-19, then that time government has launched several awareness program and acted as a guardian for the public or the population, and helping out with the new and modern technologies to get aware population. Convert people as resource into human capital, we need to invest in their skill and training. After getting good education and taken care of their health, now the third step becomes very important, that is to give them training so that they can become very proficient in their area and nation can progress out of their efficiency. So these are the area out of which we can see that how human capital adds the Indian economy or the economy of any nation. So these are the three. So at last we can conclude like this, that human capital requires three very important things. These are number one, that is their education, good health, and third is their training. And that training should be based upon their skill-based training. So these are the three things which adds the human capital and leads the country towards the progress.
The story of Shakal and Vilas illustrate how people can try to become more productive resource. Shakal was a 12-year boy. His mother Sheila looked after domestic work. His father Butta Chaudhary worked in an agricultural field. Shakal helped his mother in domestic work as well. He also looked after his younger brother Jitu and sister Situ. His uncle Shyam had passed the matriculation exam but was sitting idle in the house as he had no job. Butta and Sheila sent Shakal to the village school from where he completed his higher secondary examination. Later, his father raised a loan for Shakal to study a vocational course in computer. After completion of course, he got a job in private firm. He even designed a new kind of software, which helped him increase the sales of the firm. His boss acknowledged his service and rewarded him with a promotion. So, with this story, we understood that education added to the quality of his labor. This enhanced his total productivity of the firm in the form of salary. Also, it added the growth of the nation's economy. Let us see the case of Vilas. Vilas was an 11-year-old boy. Vilas' father Mahesh was a fisherman. His father passed away when he was only 2 years old. His mother Geeta sold fish to earn money to feed the family. She sold fish from the landowner's pond and sold it to the nearby mandi. She could earn only 20 to 30 rupees per day by selling fish. Vilas became a patient of arthritis. His mother could not afford to take him to the doctor. He could not go to the school either. He was not interested in the studies, and he helped his mother in cooking and also looked after his younger brother Mohan. After some time, his mother fell sick and Vilas was forced to sell fish in the same village. He liked his mother's earn only a meager income. So, in the case of Vilas, there was no education or health care in the early part of his life. He spent his life selling fish like his mother. Hence, he earned the same amount of unskilled labor. Before ending up today's lecture 1 of this chapter, let's do knowledge checker. When investment is made in the form of education and medical care, the quality of population improves and it becomes a great asset. This is called as fixed capital, human capital, physical capital, or both of them. Japan get developed by investing in human capital, borrowing money from World Bank, or developing agriculture sector or improving the infrastructure. Thank you for watching. Catch you soon in second lecture. Till then, stay tuned and happy.